الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أما بعد أيها الأحبة fasting during Dhul Hijjah is one of the righteous deeds which can gain us, help us to get to paradise, help us to enter on the day of judgment into the Bab Rayyan, the door of Rayyan, which is a door in paradise. It can also gain us forgiveness in this life for the sins that we've committed. And all of us have committed sins, ayu al-ahabba, and all of us are in need of forgiving, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us and forgive you. Ameen, ya Rabbil Alameen. Ayu al-ahabba, the ninth of Dhul Hijjah, which is approaching, is the day of Arafah, the day when the Hajjaj, they stand on the day of Arafah, and they supplicate to Allah, asking for what they need, asking for what they want, seeking forgiveness, and seeking the grace and favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And for us that are not on the Hajj, on the great pilgrimage, that this day is also a blessed day in which we should strive to fast. And that we can gain immense reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a forgiveness for our sins that we committed in the year before and in the year after. As the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam mentioned, and in the hadith an Abi Qatada radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, anna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam su'ila an sawm al-ithnain faqala qala nabiy sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in another hadith, قال عليه الصلاة والسلام, this is also the hadith of Abi Qatada. عن أبي قتادة رضي الله تعالى عنه قال, قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, صيام يوم عاشوراء احتسب على الله أن يكفر السنة التي قبله. So this is أيها الأحبة for يوم عاشوراء. And أيها الأحبة, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said in another hadith about Yawm Arafah, which is also the hadith of Abi Qatada as well. An Abi Qatada radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, an Nabiyya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qal, Siyam Yawm Arafah ahtasib ala Allahi an yukaffir as-sana alati qabluhu wa sana alati ba'duhu. And this is narrated Ruahu Muslim. And Imam Nawawi rahimahullah ta'ala said regarding this hadith, he said, Marad biha as-sagair. So this is very important for us, ayu al-ahabba. So let's take a look at this hadith of Abi Qatada radiallahu ta'ala anhu. So Abi Qatada radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he narrated that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, fasting the day of Arafah, that the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that he will expiate or forgive the year which came before it and the year that comes after it. And this was collected in Sahih Muslim. Imam Nawawi said, rahimahullah ta'ala, about this hadith, he said that what is meant by the kafara here, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala expiates your sins, or that this is an expiation for your sins, is that fasting Yawm Arafah, that it expiates the minor sins. Imam Nawawi said, as-sagair. Because as we know, ayu al-ahabba, that if you want your major sins forgiven, they require tawbah. They require not simply doing some of these righteous deeds that are azim, that are great deeds, that gain major forgiveness, but the most correct view, as Imam Nawawi explained, and other imams, that a lot of these actions that refer to gaining forgiveness, whether it be the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, where he said, "Al-jumwatu al-jumwatu kafaratan lima baynahuma wal-hajj mabrur laysa lahu jazaa'a al-jannah." وَالْعُمْرَةُ وَالْعُمْرَةُ كَمَا قَالَ النَّبِي صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said in an authentic hadith that Jumwa to Jumwa and Umrah to Umrah and Hajj are a forgiveness for those things, those actions that come between them. And that for the Hajj, there is no reward for it, meaning an accepted Hajj, except Jannah. So that shows us the great, immense reward of Hajj. But ayyuhal ahabba, the point being of mention in this hadith, is showing that the forgiveness that is mentioned here, as the ulama explained, between Jumu'ah to Jumu'ah, and between making your Umrah, the lesser pilgrimage, to the lesser pilgrimage, is the minor sins, ayyuhal ahabba. It's not the major sins. So meaning if you're doing adultery, if you're drinking alcohol, if you're doing major sins like backbiting and namima and carrying wicked tales around the community about people, that these sins are only forgiven, you require from us tawbah. So we have to strive to make forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and seek tawbah, repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with determination in our hearts, leaving the sins, distancing ourselves from the sins and feeling sorrow and vowing our, you know, making it impingent upon ourselves to not go back to those sins. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us and grant us the reward of Dhul Hijjah and the reward of all of our deeds that are good, and forgive us of all of our wicked sins. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.